Welcome back to my channel. Thank you for joining me for today's video. So today we are going to be doing a drugstore slash affordable makeup date night look. So we're going to be trying out Catrice Cosmetics, and this bag that they gave me at Gen Beauty was full of their top rated products. I mean, if you want to do your makeup with me, we could get ready for date night together, because I actually do have a date tonight with my hubby. Like, if you're going out, even if you don't have a date, who cares? I'll be your date. Let's have a makeup date. Let's do that. Let this be our makeup date together. Okay. We're going to start with the Catrice Cosmetics Prep and Fine Pore Refining Anti-Shine Base. This is a mattifying primer, and it says it's long-lasting and oil-free. I get very oily in my T-zone area, and especially my nose. If you can see it now, I think maybe it's showing in the camera. I mean, it's really oily already. This is different. It looks kind of like a lotion. I'm gonna focus on my nose because that's one of my worst oily areas. All right. My skin feels hydrated though. I like it. All right, Catrice, so far you're doing good, girl. Catrice Cosmetics does have a foundation, but I did not get the foundation. So I'm going to go in with my trusty old dusty L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte in shade 108. This is the Jessie's Girl sponge. It's very interesting because it has this flat oval side, and then it has this dome cone shaped tip. It's very soft, but it's more dense than a beauty blender. So I'm just gonna use that, and I'm gonna put the foundation on. It does a really good job. I like this sponge a lot. So my forehead is darker around, as you can see. I think it'll pick up on camera, I'm not sure. But it is darker than the rest of my face. But I always try to just match everything. Like, I just want one tone all over my face. As you can tell right here, I have a little bit of a bald spot. That's because when I was younger, I ran into something in my aunt's house. I don't know what it was. And I have a scar, and hair has never grown back there. The girls at the salon used to tell me that's because I used to wear too many ponytails and my hair is like pulled back, and so like now I have a bald spot, but that makes no sense. I did stop wearing ponytails for a really long time after that, so I did get really scared. I'm just gonna cover my eyes because I have hyperpigmentation all around my eyes, so put whatever is left on there. I'm gonna just set this with the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Pressed Powder. This is in the shade Warm Beige. I find that with a brush, I hate using this powder. So I always use like a fluff. So my fluff is dirty, don't judge me, because I don't use it on nobody else. It's just me, my fluff, okay. I'm just gonna press this. I'm gonna focus on the areas that get the most oily. Now on to the brows. So for brows, I have this Morphe Brow Palette. So it comes with 6 shades for your brows, 6 brow powders, and then 2 concealers. I hate these concealers. I just don't use them. I stay away from them. I use a mixture of the 2 darkest ones. The brush that I use to mix everything, this Morphe E29 brush, because it's dual-sided, it has a spoolie on it, and then it has this angled tip. First, spoolie out my brows, so I spoolie them. If I have any foundation, this is the perfect way to kind of get rid of whatever's on your brow. So I will just brush them through, following the natural shape that they go. I spoolie as I go because I don't want to add too much. I just want enough for my brows to look natural. Natural brows just kind of go a long way. I don't like to go crazy with my brows because date night, we're usually out and about in the streets. I ain't trying to scare nobody with my brows. Oh, here we go, filling it in. I haven't done my brows in a very long time, so they might be a little thick. But then, of course, you can always go in with a concealer and kind of make it a little bit smaller. I don't want to spend too much time on this video, so I'm just going to do my brows, and I'm going to come right back, and we're going to get the ball rolling. Now, I checked them on camera. They're not that bad, but in person, it's just a bit too much. So what I'm going to do is take a little more of the Infallible foundation and put a little excess in the back of my hand, and I'm just gonna go in and try to just tame this just a little. It's just a little too big for my liking. Okay, so let's go for the eyes next. They gave me these liquid metal shadows. This is called We Are the Champagnes, and this one is What Do You See? but like the sea. And if you open it up, it looks like the ocean. I've already put something on my lids, but I am going to put a little bit more. The Catrice Prime and Fine Duo Stick. This is for medium skin. This has a contour and a highlight side. So I'm gonna take the highlight side, and then I'm going to just prime my eye with this. Okay, so this is the Morphe 350. I'm gonna use this as my champagne, as my transition colors. I'm gonna take this color right here, mix it with this color, and set my eye. Set the whole thing, like under my brow bone, my lid, the whole shebang. And hopefully you can see these. Thanks. And I'm just gonna set. I just got this Lisa Frank crease brush from Glamour Dolls Cosmetics. $5. It was really, really inexpensive. I'm gonna go in with a transition color. I typically don't like to go for the oranges right away. I like to go for something that's just deeper than my skin tone and then really just pack on the color. And these two right here, they're just deeper than my skin tone. And then I'm just gonna go into my crease with it. And I'm gonna work this in there. And I'm gonna go in circular motions because sweeping motions just don't work for me all the time. I didn't realize that my camera stopped recording. Oh, so I did my transition color and then I just added, I deepened the sides with some brown and I used this IBY crease brush for that. I'm just using kind of like a warm brown. Just use any warm brown you have. I'm gonna use this one right here. Focus on the inner corners right here. I'll go in with my fluffier crease brush and blend it out. I'm gonna take some of this highlight stick. I'm gonna put it at the back of my hand. And then I'm gonna try to put a little bit of this onto my lid so that the gold, the champagne color pops. Here we go. The Morphe M425. I'm just gonna take some of this. I'm just gonna try to put this on. I find that this is like the best technique is always put something on your lid for that lid color to pop. I'm gonna use the same brush to just pick up the color. Ooh, with a brush, that looks really pigmented. Put it on my lid. Here I have the NYX Epic Ink Liner. And I'm gonna test it. Ooh, yes. Yeah, just gonna go with like a thin line. I have not been into the cat liner lately, so let's do it. All right, let's see how I feel. I'm gonna try to straighten this out a little. I'm really trying to not go for any wings. I'm really trying. Oh. There it goes, a wing started. Oh my god. How did this happen to me? I didn't want to do this. Ah! It's getting thicker by the second. No. Stop that. Okay, so after a little bit of a fiasco with my liner, which I fixed, and I went in with the Demi Wispies in 01. This is a Kiss product. I also went in with some duo glue. Everything you can find in a beauty store or a drugstore. Now we're going to go on to the face. So I'm going to go in with the Catrice Sun Glow Bronzer. Let's see how it goes. Oh yeah, it's pretty. I gotta say, honestly, I'm like, Catrice is blowing my mind. My nose is like crooked. It's always been crooked for some reason. I'm gonna go in with the Contour Duo Stick. Under here. Don't really like it for under eye. blends pretty quickly. I just feel like it's kind of red. Bring it down to my neck area and my double chin area. Like my chin has like cellulite on it. Who has cellulite on their chin? I do. Of course I do. Yeah, I think this is just way too much red on my face. I'm not crazy about it. I don't really like it that much. I'm going in with the Catrice Highlighting Powder. This is Champagne Campaign. These names are really cute though. I'm going in with my Tarte fan brush. And we're just gonna pop that in here. See how this performs. Oh. I also like to go under my brow bone just a little bit. And right here on the sides of my forehead. Just a little. I'm gonna go in with the same brown that I had used for my crease, just to create some balance to my eye. I have this really interesting mascara from Jessie's Girls called Dial a Lash that you can change the shape of the brush. So there's a little knob here at the tip of the handle, and you can just turn it. But you can turn the dial, and it changes the shape of the mascara wand. So, 4 is max volume. It maximizes lash length, thickness, and curl. So I'm always gonna want to be on 4. I am so over the noises in this neighborhood. I need to get a microphone. So if you guys have any recommendations for microphones, please let me know in the comments below, because I need to do something about the sound quality of my videos. You know, some people don't put mascara on their lashes, like on the false lashes, but I love to because it just gives me that extra boost. And now we're going to do lips. So I'm going to take my NYX. This is the natural lip liner. Line my lips with this. And of course, I just overline it just a little bit. I'm just going to make sure I have a nice even coat of this. So now I was going to put it on without telling you. The Catrice Infinite Shine Lip Gloss. I've been so into gloss lately. What color is this? Rose, would you? Question mark. I don't get it. Do you guys get it? I don't get it. And this is the final look. I have to say, all in all, I really do love the Catrice brand. Thank you so much for watching my video. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel. There's gonna be more videos coming ahead. Don't forget that I'm also on social media. You can follow me. Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, you'll find me there. And talk to me, come and ask me questions. Let me know other videos that you'd like to see, things you'd like me to try out. Just let's connect and write to me. But thank you so much for watching this video. You know, you're here. You can click on another video. I just did a FabFitFun unboxing.